Okay guys, so this is what's going on. So today I'm going to be working on swapping valve followers, and this is what's why I'm doing it. So this is cylinder number 8, and this is the intake side and this is the exhaust side. So basically this is how it goes. This valve clearance here, which is measured under here, is 12 thousandths of an inch. Earlier when it was colder, it was measured at 13 thousandths of an inch. So basically what that means is that this little follower here, okay, is not right anymore. It's worn out too much. And just this one, and I'll show you here. This is my documentary right here. When we first started it, as you can see here, it's 13 thousandths of an inch. Okay, and this side is 13 thousandths of an inch, and that side is 8 thousandths of an inch, and that's the clearance here. So what I'm going to do today is, you see that engine right there? Okay, some of you might not agree with me, but I'm going to be swapping parts. Okay, I'm going to be swapping followers here. So this is what I'm doing. I'm going to go and take out those followers in here on top of my engine there, and I'm going to measure them, okay? And because what it is I've already measured this one right here. Oh, actually this one, okay? And it's measured at 8 thousandths of an inch. The clearance is down here. I'll show you. This is my feeler gauge, and okay. So as you can see, it says, I don't know if you could see it here. Let's see. Focus. Come on. Focus. Okay. So 8 thousandths of an inch right there. So this thing goes in, right? And this thing goes in too. So watch, and I'm trying to put, alright, see, now I'm going to insert 9 thousandths of an inch into it. Watch this, it won't go in, see, it won't go in. So the clearance is 8 thousandths of an inch, room temperature. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to be swapping this follower here. So that means I'm going to be taking off this, the whole valve train here, and I'm going to take that follower out, swap it with that one over there, okay? And well, before I take it out, I have to measure the tolerance in the follower, and I'll show you when I get it done. So if you're interested, keep watching guys. This is what I'm doing. Some of you might not agree with me on this. Some of you might say, you know what, just go to the store and buy a follower. But you know what, I have spare parts all over here, so why not use this? So here we go. Okay guys, so you look at here, this is the follower. Oh, that's the follower right here, and I just dropped the shims. Okay y'all, so as you can see here, this is the shim, this is the follower. Okay, this is where the valve lobe hits constantly, and this is what wears out. Okay, or vice versa. This can wear out too. So you can see there's marring right here. Okay. The inside there looks like this, and this looks like that. So I have this guy and his buddy right there out. So we're gonna measure the we are going to be measuring the shim height, thickness, okay? And I'll give you a readout. Okay. Okay guys, so this is what I did. I've marked the valve shims here like this. I'm doing this one right here, okay? F stands for follower, S stands for shim. So right now, we're doing this one, right? The shim on this one, okay? So right now, you get your handy dandy micrometer. So I'm gonna put it as 96 thousandths of an inch. Okay, I'm gonna put 96 thousandths of an inch. Okay, so okay, so 0.096. Okay, this is the shim. Okay, that's the shim. Now let's do the follower, and the follower is kind of tricky, and here's the reason why, because the follower is way deep. Okay. 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 Yep. Okay, so it's 0.213. That's my recording. Okay, so that's my recording on this two sides, on this side. So what I'm gonna do, okay, is let's make sure this thing's zeroed out. It is zeroed. Okay guys, so this is the result here. Okay, the shim here is 93 thousandths of an inch. Oh, this one, 93 thousandths of an inch, 92 thousandths of an inch. This is 96 thousandths of an inch, 95 thousandths of an inch. Okay, so we're gonna use this one to swap it over there, but before we do that, we're gonna have to take out the other one. Okay, so now with this one, the reason why we're gonna be a little bit more delicate on this one is because we are going to be using it. The other, that engine over there is dead, so we could be a little bit, well, we could be as abrupt as we can to that one. But with this one right here, we're gonna have to be a little bit delicate. Okay, see this right here? This is the tummy mark, okay? Ideally, it should be pointing to that spot right here. But this is to let you know, it's not really pointing to that spot. However, it's pointing a little bit to the side. Okay, so that's where I am going to remember that this is how it was. Okay, and then here's the thing. Okay, and let's see. Okay, you see those little tooth marks right there? They are actually right on each other, like that. Okay, they are actually right on each other. So that's how we need to be Okay. You see this little tiny mark right there, that little dimple? Okay. It's on that side. See that little tiny mark right there, that little dimple right there? Okay. We have to remember that that's where they are supposed to be. Okay. And I'm gonna mark those. Okay. So that when I put it back, they need to be the same way that I took this thing out. The same position. Okay, if I don't do that, then it's out of time, and the engine ain't gonna run. So I gotta go mark it out. Okay guys, so I have marked that little spot right there. Okay, grounded that. Okay, there you go. Okay, so when I put this thing in, this part has to be right there. Okay, and as you can see here, okay, so they see these little marks right here, grounded in there, and I've ground a little pit right there, right here and right there, so these two have to match. Okay, and see this right here. Oops. Okay, see this little grounded area that I have right here. Okay, this has to be right here. You see those two little dots right there? Those are timing marks too, but I'm gonna make this go right there. And those are my custom timing mark. See right here, they point up to here. Okay, and so you see those little two tiny little dots right there? That's how they are right now. So everything's good, I'm gonna tear it down now. Okay guys, so I got this thing out, and this is the shim in here. I have my micrometer here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna check the shim. Okay, so remember how I said this is out of whack? So basically you get the micrometer and I'm going to get my little book here that I registered, and let's see how much the shim is. Okay, and then we're going to do some math. How thick the shim is, I meant. Okay. Okay, it's 93. Okay, so the other ones, okay, so 93, 96. So I'm gonna have to, this is 93, okay. This is 93 right here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, cause it's like this, guys. Okay. 93 thousandth of an inch, okay. That's 93 thousandths of an inch. Ideally, we are looking for a 8 thousandth of an inch gap. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna put this here. Okay. I'm gonna go get my pin. Okay, so we're gonna measure the follower here. Okay. And we have it at 0.213. Okay. 0.213 Okay. So now what we're gonna do is what we're gonna do is we're gonna go and take out the 0.96 shim and we're gonna swap it into here. Okay. And so this is how I'd record it. You can look at here. This is 0.093. That's 93 thousandth of an inch. That's 0.096. That's about 3 thousandth of an inch more. We're going to be adding this to here. Okay. And then we'll see what happens. Okay. Okay, guys. So this is the equations. Okay. So to get the new shim, okay, you have to get the values for the valve clearance, okay, the current valve clearance, and the value for the specified valve clearance, and the old shim, okay, see that? So it's the current valve clearance minus the specified valve clearance plus the old shim. So with mine, it's 12 thousandths of an inch for the old, for the current valve clearance. The ideal clearance I'm looking for is 9 thousandths of an inch. That's the book value. So the maximum allowable valve clearance was between 6 and 10 thousandths of an inch. So to me, 9 thousandths is safe, okay? And the current value for the shim is 0.093, which is 93 thousandths of an inch. So, you do the math, 12 thousandths minus 9 thousandths of an inch equals 0.003, which is 3 thousandths of an inch, plus 93 thousandths of an inch. Okay, so add that together, you have 96 thousandths of an inch. That's what I'm looking for. That's the value. Okay, so as you can see here, the values of the old engine that I have is that one. Okay, that's the 96 thousandth of an inch. That's the shim I want. So let's go get the one I want. Okay, so let's go get the one I want. Okay, guys, so you see this? That's one valve here, the other valve there. That's the one I want. So out comes this one. Okay. And then out comes the shim. There he is. Okay, so let's go measure to make sure it's 96 thousandths of an inch. Okay. Okay, so we're going to measure. The value we are looking for is 96 thousandths of an inch. So. It's almost 96 thousandths of an inch. So that's the value we are looking for. Okay. So that should do it. So what we're going to do, guys, is we are going to replace it. Okay. So where's my little book? Okay, so look at here. Let's look at our little drawing specs that we drew, our handy dandy book. So it is cylinder number 8, which is this one right here, and it is that one right there. Okay. 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 There you go. That's the one. Okay. So let's go measure this against the other one again. Okay, so this one right here, that's the 96 thousandths. Okay. See, that's 93 thousandths. See, that's almost 96 thousandths. Yeah, you're crowning it off to 96 thousandths. So that's what I'm gonna use. And let's clean that thing off. Okay. We don't have to clean that off. What we're gonna do is we are going to drop this little bad boy in. There you is. Okay. I'm gonna put a little bit of oil here. Okay, that goes in. Dab a little bit of oil in here, and then put this in here like so. We are good. I'm going to spray some acetone into here to clean that. Maybe I'll just put oil there to clean that. Okay. So then I'm gonna try and put this thing back in, and I'm gonna fast forward this. Okay guys, so as you can see here, I've tightened these bolts onto here, but I haven't torqued it in, okay? So tomorrow I'll be torquing it in, and let's measure. I know that this is not ideal yet, but let's measure here. Okay. It's not tightened yet, but let's measure anyway. 10,000 of an inch here. Nope. Oh. Goes right in. Okay, so that takes 11,000 of an inch. Hopefully when we tighten it tomorrow, it'll go in. Okay, so now it won't let it will not let 12,000 go in. Let's see. Oh, I lied. 12,000 went in. Okay. Well, okay, I can see why. Because it's not tight yet. See this? All of this goes in. So tomorrow we'll be tightening this to spec, and we'll. Okay, guys. So I decided that I want to finish this up. I went ahead and built this on. I built these on. I haven't torqued it to spec. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill. I'm going to check the valve clearance here. Okay, it should be back to between 8 and 10, okay, because I changed that little shim, okay. So I haven't torqued any of these to spec yet, but hopefully it'll work, and I'll show you how I align this. Okay, see this? Remember that mark? Okay, and that little scratch over there? So that's aligned, okay. Where it was supposed to be, and remember that mark right there, okay, that I scratched. Okay, that mark right there, I scratched that and it aligns to right here. This is an alignment mark right here, but the way it is, I'm using this part right there, the scratch right here, okay, and it's gonna align to this. And remember these two little marks right here? Okay, these two marks. Well, anyway, this is aligned to that little scratch right here. This is aligned to that little scratch right there. Okay, yeah, see that? Scratch, mark. So it's all of them are aligned. So, so let's do this. Yeah, that's 1/10 of an inch. Okay, good. It won't go in. This won't go in as well. Okay, so let's go to a thinner gauge. This is 7/1000 of an inch. I am looking for 8/1000. Okay, let me put this on hold. Okay, so this is 9/1000 of an inch. I don't know if you can see that. There you go. 9/1000 of an inch. Let's go in here. Won't fit. Okay. And that's what I was looking for. Okay, so that's 7/1000 of an inch. We are looking for the next thinner one. Oh, here it is. 8/1000 of an inch. Okay, guys, so goes right in. That's 8/1000. Okay. And that goes in. And this hasn't gone in, but that's okay. It's between 6 and 10, so that's okay. So that's 6, this is 6,000, that's 8,000. So goes in. So this is probably about 7,000. So it's good, guys. So that's that. If you think this is informational to you and teaches you how to do valve clearance on the Toyota Tundra 4.7 V8, please like and subscribe. So thank God this part is done. Tomorrow what I'm going to do is I'm going to put camshaft seals here. I'm going to reseal this part right here with silicone so that it won't leak, and then I'm going to tighten these to spec. Okay. Right now, these are not tightened to spec, so that's that. But anyway, I'm done. As far as changing the shims here, I was afraid that I wouldn't be able to do it, but it's just common sense. So I'm very happy. It's not that hard. So anywho, that's that.